Hey everybody, Clorf here again. Welcome back to the Dream Machine. I still have to figure out how to open the damn elevator doors. But anyways, let's take a look around and see if we can find anything to help do that. There's nothing in the fridge. Okay. Let's check the living room. Bathroom? Conditioner? Shampoo? Nope, can't pick it up. Skin lotion, maybe? No. I can pick up the baby oil! Woohoo! Okay! That's a lubricant. Let's see if we can open up the elevator doors. Doggone. Ha! Finally can open up doors. Hey! First floor. Yay! I made it out! Door's locked. Okay. Can... Okay, let's look through the hatch. Hello, Mr. Morton. What can you tell me about the estate? His research? Oh, crap. That's weird. Okay. What can you tell me about the other inhabitants? They keep to themselves, mostly. It's a pretty quiet house, and that's the way I like it. Apart from you and me, there are three other inhabitants in the estate. Top floor is Mr. Willard. He doesn't get out much due to his disability. Next to him lives Miss Theed. She works as a night nurse at Abbey Hospital. She's asleep during the day, so I rarely see her. And next to you, we have Mrs. Jones, a widow since a few years back. I'm afraid her age is starting to get the better of her. Yeah, she's upstairs playing canasta or something right now. But on a good day, she's still quite lucid. No, nothing else right now. Let's, open the left door. Can't open the left door, because... Yeah, okay. Let's enter the lobby, see if our furniture's here. Yeah, yep, hey, hi. I am. Excellent. Ooh, she's pregnant. Fine. Pain in my ass. Ooh, crowbar. Oh, Auto-saving. Okay, saved. Can we use that? Can I? Tempting, but no. Screw bar with mover. Okay, well, this is another, ventilation grate. We keep getting into more and more trouble here now, don't we? It seems to be permanently stuck. Yay me. Sir, yeah, okay. You're a bit interesting. Can you help me with my sofa, maybe? Nah, I just dumped it there. Fine. Can we? Let's. Well, at least she's coming out. Hi. Thank you. I'd ring my own doorbell, but I know better. Han! Alicia? Honey? Dearest? Oh, hell, where'd she go? In the bathroom. Nope. Han? Nope. Maybe she's in the living room. Honey? Hi. I have good news and I have bad news. The good news is the furniture is here. The bad news is the furniture is still downstairs. Okay. So that was wonderful. Oh, hang on. I've got a crowbar. I can open up that thing now. Let me get back to the bedroom. Nobody can pry it open with this. Haha! This crowbar snapped. Of course it snapped in half, because those cheap bastards. Okay, let's see. Okay. Is this what we want? I don't know. So let's see if we can follow this. That comes down here. Everything is lined up, however, it doesn't mean I don't want to do things like that. Power comes in through here or out through here? I can't be sure. Getting closer. Wait, does lit mean it has power? I hate these things. Okay, I'm starting to get the hang of this, I think. That makes no difference to that. They're all lit. Maybe just get things through with the shortest path, so that would be skip the fewest resistors. I'm hitting one resistor. Hang on. There we go. I think I finally figured it out. Great, now I need a fuse of some kind. Great. Okay. Can I find any sort of... No. may concern. I'm hiding. Hope you find it. Not paranoid. Look under the floorboard in the bedroom. Figured out. Previous tenant. Han? Do we have a fuse? Oh, hang on. Do I have one in the guitar? Nope. That would make sense. Han, you left the water on. Can I try the apartment key? Let's give that a shot. Oh, hang on. Thank you. We're wasting water. Don't do that. I love you, Alicia, but stop wasting water. Okay, key. Key. Yes, but where specifically? Okay, then. Looks like a camera. Yes, a camera. Hey, several electronics. Okay. I want to go down and beat the shit out of him. Let's go down and talk to him. No, by the way, here's that crappy IKEA print on the wall. We installed the camera behind it. Okay, you do that. I'm headed downstairs. Because that is some weird shit. Go downstairs, into the elevator, down here. Mr. Morton! You weird bastard. If he managed to move the damn couch. Nope. Oh, hang on. Okay, I'm gonna need the coat hanger. Excuse me. Can we, can we open the lock? I don't know how to pick locks. Okay, how about the window? Mr. Window. Thank you. Leave. Yeah, won't be for long. Key? End chapter one. Interesting. I know you're in here. We found your camera. Chapter two, the little man who wasn't there. Pick up stamp. Examine the toolbox. Anything in here? Anything I can pick up? Nope. Oh, I can pick up a book though. Let's do that. How about this shelf? How about the gramophone? Doggone it! Okay, so pick up a piece of paper. Frankly, if it's going, I'm gonna blank. May 4th, 1973. Interesting. Okay, it was April 4th, right? Wait a second, hang on. What's the date on this thing again? May 4th. 5-4. Let's read this book again. 5-4. May 4th. What a strange dream. My heart sang a beautiful song. Then a moon-shaped package arrived. The stars turned on me. I was frightened by the fact the sun was missing. Waves fell gently on some faraway beach. I have to say, it feels better having written this down. Let's check the previous pages. Night terrors again. This one quite bad. I was engulfed by a terrifying wave. My heart sang a beautiful song. I remember the song. It had a strange tint of blue. A single star shone over a house. I strongly recall something odd about the moon. I swear the ground seemed to shift in dreams. Have to write this dream down, lest I forget. I strongly recall something odd about the moon. I remember that the sun had a strange tint of blue. I was standing between two colliding waves. Stars turned on me. I saw candy hearts falling into a black hole. I'm sure on the threshold of virgin territory. April 3rd, next night. I had a foreboding dream last night. Wave was building up, moon was there, but the rest of the sky was missing. Something knocked me out. I could see stars. The sun talked in a language only I could understand. I recall a sharp pain as my heart stopped beating. These night terrors have to stop. Okay, May 4th we've read, June 8th. Another foreboding dream. The moon was just there, it was there, but the rest of the sky was missing. Interesting. Waves fell gently on some faraway beach. My heart was racing. I couldn't stop it. Stars went out like candles. One by one, the sun talked in a language only I can understand. I fear for my sanity. I fell out of bed twice. Moon started pulling me towards it. I was following the star, frightened by the fact the sun was missing. A strange dream. The sun talks only in a language he understands. Kind of glancing through here real fast. Fell out of bed twice. Okay, give me back to May 4th. Beautiful song. Stop. Turn the handle on the gramophone. Turn counterclockwise. Turn clockwise. No. Let's examine the other room. Look under bed. Examine bed. Examine the bookcase. Hang on here. I didn't do anything. Okay. Sun. He's had a lot of dreams. Okay. So I can check them all out, but the key seems to be May the 4th. Songs on. Moon, stars, waves. Not quite sure I understand this. Clockwise, counterclockwise. Let's try that. Nope. I think we might be stuck again. Okay, I think we might be stuck again for a little bit, so I think we're gonna leave this one here. But we made it through chapter one, I'm down the elevator, and my sofa is stuck in the damn entryway. Whatever. We'll figure this out next time. I'll go through the journals, and we will figure out what to do and what this scrawl is and what it means. So until next time, thank you all again for watching. If you like this video, go on ahead and give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions, comments, suggestions on the puzzle, you know, by all means, leave suggestions. We will see about getting into this secret entrance and doing what we can. But until next time, thank you again. My name is Glorf. We'll see you next time. Nice shot. Oh, I see. I have so many action points. Gotcha. Watch out. Ow. Ow.